In Tampa, just like my last question when I mentioned Oakland, it's a perfect transition.
We didn't plan this.
We did not.
Like, we don't tell each other questions before. This has been seamless today.
Surprise question. And we had the same thing in our NBA podcast earlier today about the Warriors. I said, Steph Curry, don't ask that. That's my last question. Although, I'll tell you, Tampa Bay lost to the Toronto Blue Jays today.
Fucking Blue Jays.
Tampa Bay is now at 13-1. But they started off the season 13-0.
Time for Tampa to panic?
Yes, because they have a very low payroll. Actually, I don't know if I had a... I didn't really write a question here, but I'm just going to read it to you. They're the fourth lowest payroll in baseball. Started the season 13-0. They're paying the team less than what the Mets are paying two pitchers. Crazy to see. They paid a pitcher last year, 3 years, $40 million. That was their largest signing in franchise history. $40 million. And the 13-0 start is the best start since St. Louis went 20-0 in 1884.
Twitter was going nuts in 1884.
Yeah, they were like, 20-0? What does this mean for baseball?
Gee golly.
What does this mean for baseball? The fourth lowest payroll. A team that just paid a guy $40 million, and that's their most ever. They are paying their team, like I said, the same amount as two Mets pitchers. Less than two Mets pitchers are getting paid. And they're 13-0, the best team in baseball. What does this say about the sport? Because we see a lot of teams, like the Angels, have the two best players in baseball probably and haven't made the playoffs in 8 years, tied for the longest drought. I know this is like the Moneyball method, and it's like it gets used by everyone now. Yeah. Like, do you see a place where baseball teams are just not going to keep paying these guys $350 million and go with like quality players for better prices and have a better lineup?
It depends on the market. Simple as that. New York has money to spend. They'll spend the money. Tampa doesn't have the money to spend. They won't spend the money.
Then why are these teams turning out like just as good, if not better, a lot of the years?
Because they're run smarter. They're not run on just blank checks. They're run on analytics and Moneyball and so many different factors that they have to actually think about. It's much easier to run an organization, be the GM of the Mets and just pay a pitcher $150 million versus being Tampa Bay and have to actually go draft some players.
What do you think Tampa Bay will do, though? Like, if they get that guy.
Move to Montreal?
No, who do they have right now? Rizarina, right?
And Wander Franco.
Yeah. $40 million is the most they've ever paid a player in the history of their franchise. Are they going to continue this, or do you think they're going to be like, you know what, like, when we get this guy, we'll give him $100 million?
They might pay Franco $41 million and tell him just...
Sir, it's a franchise record. Like, you're the highest paid player ever in the history of franchise. He's like, dude, there's pitchers getting $40 million.
This team is run like the Miami Marlins or Florida Marlins back then. They won two World Series doing this. If this works for them. They've done this. They've been to a World Series before. This works for them.
But how long? You can see the Oakland A's right now. Mm-hmm. It's not working anymore. And they keep using Moneyball as an excuse.
Kind of doesn't work. They made the playoffs 2.5 years ago.
I know. They're the worst team in baseball by far right now.
And then 2 years from now, they maybe have the best record in baseball.
But is it not bad for the sport?
It's horrible for the sport.
Like, it's to me...
It's bad for the sport. I'm just saying if you're running the team, it's not bad for you.
I agree. But I'm talking about for the sport. Like, when you see a team paying... A pitcher $40 million, that's their franchise record. And it's not even, their whole roster is not even equal to two Mets pitchers.
I'll tell you what it is. The baseball next collective bargaining agreement needs to put a salary floor, not a salary cap, a salary floor.
I think they need both.
I kind of like that baseball just pays people whatever the fuck they want. Because, you know, I wouldn't
like that.
I wouldn't if it translated into World Series, but no one's dominating, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, you have the Houston Astros who pay players, but not like the Mets or the Angels or the Yankees, and they still win.
And they still like, so it doesn't matter. It hasn't hurt the sport like as far as like the Yankees can spend $1 billion, they might not win the World Series.
Yeah, I saw a TikTok yesterday about the A's, which was interesting. Which was like, you know, through the collective bargaining agreement last year, I think they got like $111 million, and their payroll was like $40 million. So without selling a single ticket, which they don't, they get like 2,000 people a game. Without selling a single beer, they're profitable like $70 million. Yeah. I think it's a clear sign that the sport, like you said, needs to put a floor. I think that's the solution to baseball: is put a floor, get these payers paid like.
And for those who don't know what a floor is, basically you have to meet a certain salary requirement that you have to pay your players.
Yeah, like whatever, like Like, you have to have a payroll of $70 million.
Yeah, you can't have a payroll of 12.
Yeah, like the Orioles. The Orioles last year, they were like two games out of the Mariners to make the playoffs, and they had like a $35 million payroll.
Yeah, you can't do that anymore.
Okay, I agree with that. I think that's the solution, because I think it's a bad sign for baseball if you come this year, and you see, and it's bad for the players if you have a team like Tampa Bay make the World Series again and they're the fourth lowest payroll. You have, like, I think it's just bad for the player situation. Like, how can you – now, don't get me wrong. Otani's worth $500 million, like, endorsements, ticket sales. But, like, how can you justify paying him $500 million when you know that's, like 10 years worth of the Tampa Bay Rays payroll and Otani hasn't been to the playoffs in his career?
Yeah, exactly.
So I think for the players, they should probably push for a floor. I mean, if you're a Rays player right now and you're 13-0, you're probably like, damn, we should be getting paid more.
Exactly, because you're playing so damn good.
Yeah. I mean, I know if I was on the Rays right now and we're 13-0, I'm like, how the hell am I getting $3 million in, like...
You'd be walking in owner's office, hey, can I get a raise? Like, nah, fuck you.
No, like, we're 13-0 with however you're getting paid. Like, okay, but... Like,
but I'm going to leave next year. All right, leave.
Leave. We'll be good. Just as good.
We got a great AAA system.
I hate it for the sport, but I do love that they went 13-0 for the sport at the same time. But I think they need to fix it.
I agree.
All right, team, fix it. I love it.